हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ लिटरेचर. ओके, आज का हमारा टॉपिक है डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. लिटरेचर रेफर्स टू दोज रिटन प्रोडक्शंस दैट हैव आर्टिस्टिक और इंटेलेक्चुअल वैल्यू और विच डिप्लॉय लैंग्वेज इन वेज दैट डिफर फ्रॉम ऑर्डिनरी यूसेज. ओके, देयर आर फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ जेनर्स इन लिटरेचर. फर्स्ट है पोएट्री. पोएट्री इज द फर्स्ट मेजर लिटरेसी जेनर. ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ पोएट्री शेयर स्पेसिफिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. इन फैक्ट पोएट्री इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ टेक्स्ट दैट फॉलोज अ मीटर एंड रिदम विद ईच लाइन्स लेवल्स. फर्दर इट इज सबडिवाइडेड into different genres: epic poem, narrative, romantic, dramatic and lyric. Dramatic poetry includes melodrama, tragedy and comedy, while other poems include ode, sonnet, elegy, ballad, songs and epics. ये सब किस में आते हैं? poetry में आते हैं. ode, sonnet और elegy, ballad, songs and epics. okay, some popular examples of epic poems are Paradise Lost by John Milton, The Odyssey and the Iliad by Homer. The romantic poems include Red Red Rose by Rembrandt, Burns, etc. All these poetic forms share specific features. They do not follow paragraphs or sentences. They use stanzas and lines instead. Poetry being basically a form of literacy are that use aesthetic and rhythmic qualities of language to evoke meaning in addition to or in a place of prosaic ostensible meaning. Poetry has been distinguished from prose by its being set in verse. Prose is cast in sentences, the poetry in lines. The syntax of prose is dictated by meaning, whereas that of poetry is held across meter. Okay, next is drama. Drama is a form of text that is performed in front of an audience. It is also called a play. The written text contains dialogues and stage directions. This genre has further categories like comedy, tragedy, tragic comedy, etc. Drama is a literature intended for performance. Often it is combined with music and dance as in opera and musical theater. A play is a subset of this form, referring to the written dramatic work of a playwright that is intended for performance in a theater. It chiefly comprises of the dialogues between characters and usually aims at dramatic or theatrical performance rather than at reading. Okay, a closest drama by contrast refers to a play written to be read rather than to be performed. William Shakespeare is known as the father of English drama. Some of his well-known play includes Taming of the Shrew, Romeo and Juliet, Hamlet, and many others. The Greek playwrights were pioneers in this field, like Sophocles, Oedipus Rex, and Antigone. Modern drama includes Death of a Salesman by Arthur Miller. Okay. Next is prose. Prose is a kind of written text that is different from poetry in that it has complete sentences organized into paragraphs. It is a form of language that possesses ordinary syntax and natural speech rather than rhythmic structure. Next types of prose. Okay, first, now novel, novella, short story, fiction, non-fiction or comedy. तो सबसे पहले हम novel के बारे में जानेंगे. The novel is a long fictional prose narrative. Its form is a close relation to real life that differs it from the chivalric romance, although there are many historical prototypes. that so called novels. Before the novel, the modern novel form emerged late in cultural history, roughly around the 18th century. Though it was entirely subject to much criticism, the novel acquired a dominant position amongst literary forms both popularly and critically. Next is novella. Novella kya hai? In purely quantitative terms, the novella exists between the novel and short story. In fact, it is too short to be a novel and too long to be a short story. There is no precise definition in terms of word or page count. Novella is a form whose identity seems destined to be disputed into perpetuity. It is suggested that the size restriction of the form produces various stylistic results, both that are shared with the novels or short story and other unique to its form. Next, short story. There is a dilemma in defining the short story as a literary form is how to or whether one should distinguish it from any short narratives. The early short story writers like Edgar Allan Poe or the clearly modern short story writers like Anton Chekhov, it has a distinct size. Various theorists have suggested that the short story has a characteristics, subject matter or structure. Next, fiction. Fiction has three categories: realistic, non-realistic and semi-fiction. Since fiction work is not real, therefore the authors can use complex figurative language to touch the reader's imagination. Unlike poetry, it is more structured, follows proper grammatical pattern and correct mechanics. A fictional work may incorporate ideas full of fantasy and imagination from everyday life. Fiction comprises some important elements like plot, exposition, foreshadowing, rising action, climax, falling action, and resolution. Okay. The popular examples of literary fiction include James Joyce's novel, A Portrait of an Artist as a Young Man, Charles Dickens' A Tale of Two Cities, Jane Austen's Pride and Prejudice, Half a List to Kill a Mockingbird, etc. Next, non-fiction. Non-fiction is a vast category that has subgenres. It could be creative like personal essay and factual like scientific paper. It may also use figurative language, though not abundantly like poetry or fiction. Sometimes it may tell a story like autobiography, and sometimes it may convey the information to the readers. Some examples of non-fiction include biographies, diaries, memoirs, journals, fantasies, mysteries, and romances. A popular example of non-fiction genre is Michael Pollan's highly celebrated book, The Omnivore's Dilemma, a natural history of four males that is an account about the eating habits of the Americans. Next, comedy. Comedy is a literary genre and a type of dramatic work that is amusing and satirical in its tone, usually having a cheerful ending. The motive of this dramatic work is triumph over unpleasant circumstances by which to create comic effects that results in successful conclusion. The purpose of humor context in which an author delivers dialogues and a delivery method that includes farce, satire and burlesque. Okay. There are five types of comedy in literature. Romantic comedy that involves in the themes of love leading to a happy ending. Next, comedy of humor explains that when the human body has a balance of humors, Hagam blood yellow vile and black vile in their bodies, they remain healthy. Next, Comedy of Manners deals with the intrigues and relations of ladies and gentlemen living in a very sophisticated society. Next, Sentimental Comedy contains both comedy and sentimental tragedy. It appears in the literary circle due to reaction of middle class against austerity and intensity of desperation. Comedy of Manners. Tragicomedy contains both tragic and comedy elements. It blends both elements to lighten an overall mood of the play. Often the tragicomedy is a serious play that ends happily. Next, function of genre. Depending upon their types, different genres have different roles. Fiction and dramatic genres help students and writers learn and improve their communication skills. Poetic genre enhances imaginative and emotional power of the readers. Next, non-fictional text and essays help readers develop analytical and persuasive capabilities. Next, however, the major function of the genre is to establish a code of behavior between the writer and the audience. It keeps the readers informed about the topic discussed or the themes presented. Okay. Thank you for watching.